Welcome to our Thanksgiving play. We hope you enjoy it. We celebrate Thanksgiving on the fourth Thursday of November.
But it wasn't always that way. In 1859, Thanksgiving was not a holiday in every state. Only a few states celebrate Thanksgiving on the same day.
A young woman named Sarah Josepha Hale decided to change that. She went to see President Abraham Lincoln to see if she could convince him to make the fourth Thursday of November a holiday for Thanksgiving forever.
Did she meet President Lincoln?
What did she tell him?
What did he say?
You'll see. Let's visit the Hale House now. Sarah is putting the children to bed.
Please, Mother, read us the poem you wrote about Mary and the lamb.
I like the part when the lamb goes to school.
Now, children, it's time to go to bed. I'll tell you one more time. Mary had a little lamb. His face was white as snow. And everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go. Followed her to school one day. That was against the rules. It made the children laugh and play to see a lamb at school.
Oh, Mother, I just love that. It's one of the best in print.
I'm glad my mother writes for magazines.
Now, children, it's time to go to the bed. I must write something very important, a letter to President Lincoln.
Mother, will he read it?
Will he write you back?
We shall see. Good night, children. Dear Mr. President,
Sarah wrote to President Lincoln many times. She even put some of her letters in her magazine.
Each time she asks him to make Thanksgiving a holiday for every American on the very same day, the fourth Thursday in November.
Then one day, President Lincoln invited Sarah to meet him at the White House.
Let's visit the White House now. Sarah is meeting President Lincoln.
Good day, Mr. President.
Hello, Miss Hill. I'm going to lectures.
Tell me, why do you think we should have a National Thanksgiving Day?
I can show you one in this book. It tells about the first Thanksgiving long ago in 1621. See, here are the pilgrims. If they had given up and gone home, we might not be here today. We should thank them and the Native Americans who helped them survive in America. Here, take a look.
Let's go back to that first harvest sign, 1621. Listen, some of the people are talking.
I'm Governor William Branson. I'm from England. Now I live in America. My people came for religious freedom.
I'm Mario Stevens. We pilgrims call ourselves separatists because we want to separate from the Church of England. We're throwing jail for wanting to pray to her.
My name is Susanna Winslow. I stayed on the Mayflower for 66 days. It was a long, hard trip to America. I was afraid we were lost.
I am Frederick Bradford. When we arrived in Plymouth in November of 1620, the men of our group signed the Mayflower Compact. It was a set of laws that we all agreed to follow so that we could live peacefully together.
I am Peter Brown. We are very happy to find fields ready for planting. We built 7 houses right away. We use hammers, nails, and thatch.
My name is Martha Brown. My brother Peter paints a pretty picture, but it's November when we arrived to this new world. We lived on the Mayflower for 4 cold winter months. With our brothers and sisters while the men built houses. We could not go across till spring.
My name is Elizabeth Hopkins. Many people became ill during that first winter. Half of the people died. My husband had a fever. I was so happy that day when Samoset walked into camp in March of 1621.
I am Samoset. I am from the Patuxent tribe. I walked into the pilgrim camp that day in March and said hello. I was the first Native American the pilgrims spoke with. I spoke little English, but I knew someone who spoke well. My friend from the Nauset tribe just wanted to.
Broadalbin Squad.
My real name is Desquanto. I spoke English well because I have been taken to England. I returned to my homeland, and with my English, I was able to help make the Native Americans speak to the English who came here to trade. I helped make peace between them. I also gave some advice about raising crops here.
I am Mary Brewster. When Tyler showed me how to plant corn, first he dug a hole, then he put your fish in, and then he filled the hole and put corn seeds on top. Now we have lots of corn.
Hi, I am Eleanor Bailey. Since our Indian neighbors have done so much for us, because of them, we have fish, fowl, and herbs. There's enough food for everyone.
Let's have a harvest celebration. Let's prepare a great feast. Let's invite our friends, the Indians.
I'll get turkey, duck, and geese.
I'll go fishing. I'll get cod, perhaps maybe an eel, too.
We'll prepare the food. We know how to cook.
We can roast, peel, pound, and slice. Let's get started.
I'll get the clay. I'm ready for baking.
I'll need the dough for bread.
I'll carry the firewood.
The pilgrim woman cooked a big cut of soup with enough to feed 50 people.
The men made long tables.
Finally, the day of the feast arrived. Here come the Native Americans.
So on the news of my people, they'll want to know, like the pilgrims, we suffered from sicknesses and diseases. We and many of us died. We are looking forward to celebrating the harvest with them. There are 90 of us here.
Hello, welcome.
There are 50. There are 53 of us pilgrims living here. Altogether, there are so many people, we may not have enough food.
Quick, pour more meat in the pot. Put more bread in the oven.
Do not worry, see, the Wampanoag have brought wild turkey and deer.
I'm hungry. Let's eat.
The pilgrim and the Native Americans sat down together. They had turkey, goose, pudding, pigeon, stuff, clove, fruit, carrot, corn, soup, pumpkin, and salad herbs.
But before they ate, Governor Bradford gave thanks.
The feast lasted for 3 days. There were games and contests, music and dancing.
Joseph Hale.
Happy Thanksgiving, everyone.
The end.